central processing unit on your computer can do just about anything. But even the craziest computer CPUs only have about 8 cores these days, which isn't nearly enough to render a complex scene in real time. Fortunately, your computer and phone also has a graphics processing unit, or GPU. GPUs are chips purpose-built to pump out pixels, and some can have thousands of cores. Each of these cores is pretty limited in what it can do, though, and groups of these cores have to work together in lockstep, each executing the same instructions each clock cycle. So while the GPU is less flexible than the CPU, it can spew out pixels at some absurd rate. So the code we run on the CPU determines what we want to draw, and then we send those instructions over to the GPU, which will actually figure out the pixel colors. To do this, we need a language for communicating between the CPU and the GPU. The most common language for this purpose is called the Open Graphics Language, or OpenGL. Smartphones use a slightly scaled-down version of this language called OpenGL ES, where the ES stands for Embedded Systems. If, in the Microsoft universe, you've ever heard of DirectX, that's a language that serves essentially the same purpose. So, to sum up, the CPU uses OpenGL to tell the GPU what to draw. The GPU builds up the actual array of colors and then ships it to the electronics that run the screen. Brief aside, I'd be failing as a nerd if I didn't mention that you can actually do far more with GPUs than just color pixels. There's a whole field of general-purpose GPU computing. Algorithms that run on GPUs need to be very clever about how they get those lock-stepping cores to work together. But when they do, they can be extremely fast, and as is often even more important these days, extremely energy efficient in terms of power per calculation.